When insufficient spice data is loaded into Cosmographia to compute the position or orientation of one or more objects at the current visualization time, the program displays a No Spice Data warning message at the top of the window. This message includes spice names of bodies and/or reference frames for which spice data is not available. When data is missing for many bodies and frames, the message will display a truncated list of names followed by an ellipsis. When there is insufficient spice data for an object, Cosmographia still renders that object on the screen. When spice trajectory data is not available to compute the position of a given object, Cosmographia renders the object in the location of its center of motion as defined by the object's catalog file. In most cases, this places the object inside the sun or the planet that the object orbits. So for example, on August 1st, 2013, the currently loaded spice data is not sufficient to compute the position of the Cassini spacecraft. Because the Cassini spacecraft catalog file defines Cassini to be orbiting Saturn during this time, if we scroll out, we can see that Cassini was rendered inside Saturn. We can also see the error message at the top of the screen stating that the data for the Cassini body is missing. Next, when spice frame orientation data is not available to compute the attitude of a given object, Cosmographia renders the object so that its body fix frame is co-aligned with the base frame defined by the object's catalog file. In most cases, the base frame will be ICRF, making the object's orientation appear constant on the screen. So let's go to a time when the Cassini mission is lacking its spacecraft frame orientation data. Now we can see the error message at the top of the screen stating that both Cassini's frame data and Cassini's trajectory data is missing. If we turn on ICRF, and we turn on the spacecraft's body fix frame, we can see that the body fix frame aligns itself with ICRF. And if we speed up time, we can see that Cassini's orientation does appear constant. In the far future or the far past, all spice-driven bodies will lack sufficient data because spice kernels included in the Cosmographia package provide for a finite span of 100 years, from 1950 to 2050. So if we go into the far future, into 2080, and if we go back to the solar system view, almost all bodies will be collapsed into the sun, and only the bodies that are not driven by spice data, such as some asteroids, will be visible. A message will appear at the top of the screen stating that a list of spice bodies and Cassini's frame data are missing. To give more detailed information about missing spice data, Cosmographia collects spice error messages and provides an option to display these messages in a separate window titled Spice Error Log. This window can be displayed only when there are spice errors. You can open this window through the top menu or the keyboard. To use the top menu, go to the menu bar, click File, and click Open Spice Error Log. To use your keyboard, press Shift Command E. Opening the spice error log displays a window that shows and keeps only the first 100 spice error messages generated within the program. These messages can be cleared from the window by clicking the Clear button. If spice errors are still occurring, such as during this time, clicking Clear will make the program record the first 100 error messages after the click. If spice errors are no longer occurring, such as during this time, clicking Clear will empty the window. The SPICE error log window can be closed at any time and can be opened again only if SPICE errors are occurring. So now, since no more errors are occurring, as can be seen from the lack of a SPICE error message, the SPICE error log cannot be opened at this time. Some familiarity with SPICE system concepts and SPICE-based Cosmographia catalog files may be needed to understand, locate, and correct SPICE errors.